Let's take a look at creating this model. The first step is always to see if there's an overall shape. If you look from the side, you can see that it is composed of a straight line and an arc. So we can begin with this sketch. This is simply a horizontal line and a tangent arc. If you wish to, you can close up this profile, but that is not necessary. We can use this to create a thin extrude. Begin the extrude command. Select the thin extrude option. Check on the chaining option and select the straight line and the arc. For direction, set to symmetric. Adjust the distance. For wall location, select side 1. This will thicken the sketch inwards. If you look at the final model again, these almost look like the faces that you would get if you perform fillets on the edges of this solid. Add fillets to these four edges. After this is done, begin a fresh fillet command and add fillets to these edges. So we have managed to create the faces that we need. From here, we need to remove the unwanted faces and at the same time hollow out the entire thing. Go to Modify, Shell. Remove the chain selection option so that we can select faces individually. Select the faces that you wish to remove. Set the thickness. So this is one way of doing it. Let's take a look at another way. Delete the shell. Let's try creating copies of these faces. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Offset. Remove the Chain Selection option. Select the faces that we need. Set the offset distance to 0. By doing this, we can create copies of these faces. Hide the solid body. One advantage of doing it this way is that we can make adjustments to this surface. Go to Modify, Extend. Perhaps we need a small straight wall all along the edges. Set type to tangent. Select these edges. Adjust the distance. Perhaps we want to decrease the size of the middle opening. Repeat the extend command. Set type to tangent. Select the inner edges and adjust the distance. This is still currently a surface body. Go to Create, Thicken. Select the surface body and set the thickness. Another way is to start by building surface bodies from scratch. Let's roll back the timeline to the very first sketch. Make sure that the Surface tab is still active. Go to Create, Extrude. Select the straight segment and the arc. Extrude this symmetrically. Go to Create, Rule. We want to create a series of walls along the edges. Check on the Chain Selection option and select all the outer edges. For Type, set to Normal. Adjust the distance. If you attempt to fill it at this point, it will not work as these are still separate surface bodies. Go to Modify, Stitch. Select both these surface bodies and stitch them into a single surface body. After you have stitched, you can treat this like a normal solid and fillet. Add fillets to these four edges. Begin a fresh fillet command and fillet these edges. So we have created the faces that we need. We are free to select faces and delete them individually. Perhaps in this case, we might want to leave a few of these flat faces. go to Create, Thicken. Select the surface body and set the thickness. Yet another way is to make use of the sweep command. I prepared a profile here. Show the surface body. We can use this chain of edges as a path to sweep. With this method, you have more freedom to construct the profile, instead of being constrained by the fillet. Go to Create, Sweep. Select the arc as a profile. For path, click on the select box and select the path. Hide the previous surface body. After this, you can thicken. So these are just a few suggestions on how to model this. I do have a tendency to overthink these models. I'm sure that there are better ways. Do let me know in the comments.